Hi there, it's Olga Zarr from SEO Slice. So in this video, I want to show you how to visualize the website structure using Screaming Frog. This is a very fun exercise, something I get very excited about every time I do it. And this even gives me this sick feeling of, I don't know how to even describe it, like feeling high when I start doing that, especially if I do it on a huge website. And the example website I am showing you isn't that huge. It has around 100 pages, and you will see that even with that small number of pages, this is a really small site, you can get into the website structure issues. Generally, like the website structure, what you need is you want Google to be able ideally to reach every page of your website, every page which you want to rank and get indexed, canonical page. You want Google to be able to reach within like 3-4 max clicks from the homepage. So here is the crawl depth of my test website, Pigeon How. And as you can see, the majority of pages are on level 2. So this is relatively easy to reach by Google. On level 3 and 4, there is like a small number of pages. And some of them, as you can see, are redirected. So they do not really matter that much. So this is a healthy crawl depth. And crawl depth, of course, is something that will dictate the website structure. What you see in like menu, when you open a site, when you navigate through a website, this isn't necessarily the website structure. The website structure is basically how Google bots like and other bots enter your website and where they go, where they land, where they cannot go, and how complicated this process becomes, whether they get stuck in some places, whether they get into like some sorts of infinite loops, like, and eventually Google, for example, can run out of crawl budget. So a website structure, especially for bigger websites, because for a website of that size, that isn't really an issue, but for bigger websites, especially e-commerce websites, this is really, really important not to mess this up, because even with a relatively small e-commerce website, say 10,000 URLs, or 30,000 URLs, which isn't that much, you can get into serious trouble if, for example, there are URLs with parameters and there isn't like clear canonicalization, there are problems with pagination. Google can add things to cart, add, remove, play with that. Then you can get into a situation where Google simply won't index your products or will not even crawl your products, will not be able to discover your products because it will keep doing all those weird things, walking through the paths it shouldn't be walking. So Screaming Frog, you basically crawl your website. I ran crawl analysis. Basically, all the data is here. And now I am going to visualize what it looks like. So the first type of visualization is crawl tree graph, very simple one, where you will simply see a graph like that showing the structure of your website. So is it really what you envision? Is it really what you thought it would be? So this is the homepage, right? Everything that is green is response code 200, okay, can be indexed, can be followed. So Google enters the homepage, then it goes here, 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 and from here, for example, it can go here, here, but the red one is something that Google cannot index. And in this case, this is the URL that is redirected. Here you can see pigeon behavior. So this is, I think, a category page. And here you can see the pagination, and pagination one is basically the dead end, which is redirected. For the website of this size, of course, this is like nothing. But as I said, for a huge website, this can really become a huge problem. So the structure doesn't look that bad. We don't have so many red circles here. So this is the simplest crawl tree graph. So here is the directory tree graph. What it looks like depends on your URL structure. Some websites, some CMS systems like Wix have always this flat URL structure. So you will have everything almost on the same level, as you can see here. So this is more or less what you will see in many websites. Sometimes websites have this subdirectory. So they, for example, have like the domain. After domain, they have, let's say, guides. And after guides, they have specific guides. So in this case, you would see simply guides and everything that's under that. WordPress websites, in many cases, are like that, flat URL structure. In WordPress websites, it is quite common. You have the domain, blog, and then the blog. And this is what it is set up in my SEO Slice website. In this case, it isn't. So that's directory tree structure. And now let's see the force directed crawl diagram. And now it's becoming a little bit more fun to watch, and it's becoming a little bit more interactive. So you can now see that it is now simply like better visualized. You can move things around. And this is fun, and this really will help you better understand the structure of the website, especially, as I said, in bigger websites. So I am now, this is the homepage, right? So I can move stuff around and I can see those other subpages. So this is this force directed crawl diagram. You also can have the same thing for directory. A directory, so if your URLs are structured in the way you use actually directories, then this chart may be more interesting, more helpful. In this case, as you can see, this is a flat URL structure. So I'm just having something in the blog paginated pages here. And these are basically all my blog posts. So a flat URL structure. And the funniest part is when you see the 3D force directed crawl diagram. So this is like the version of what Googlebot may see when it enters the website, how it all may go. Of course, Googlebot does not have to behave the same way Screaming Frog does, but very often there will be similarities, and Screaming Frog will allow you to see whether you have those loopholes, those rabbit holes on your website, which you should get rid of to basically make it easier for Google to, one, crawl the website, and two, to understand the relations between specific pages and which pages really count, which don't, because you don't want Google to be crawling the web pages which are like thin, empty, and so on. So this is the 3D one, and this is the funniest part. This is still a small website, so the fun isn't as big, but I think I will show you a different one day where it really becomes fun. So let's now take a journey here. So this is my homepage. This is one of the blog pages, and I have like a quick overview of like word count, crawl depth, unique links this specific blog post has. So you can basically take a journey through your website and its specific elements, specific sections, and better understand basically like what's the journey that Googlebot or other search engine bots have to take to understand your website, to go through all of the pages, and whether you are prioritizing some pages over others. Like, for example, you have some important content, but it is like on the 10th level of the website. So then you are clearly sending the signal to Google that this page isn't that important. Like when you have like two internal backlinks to a specific page, but other page has like 100, whatever. So very, very fun stuff. You can also do the same with the directory tree diagram, but again, what it looks like depends on your basic URL structure. So in this type of URL structure, whether Google takes into account the directory in which your specific article is, it's like there are different opinions about that. My experience shows that your URL structure is too complex, like you have an article and it is listed under blog, guides, technical, whatnot. It may perform worse, may be less important to Google, but this is just my personal observation based on my personal websites, and other WordPress websites I consulted with all helped with. So isn't that fun doing that? This is fun. Like, this is just fun, right? This is the funny part of being an SEO, when you are doing these things and they make you happy. And if someone enters your room, sees that, and they are not SEOs, they will not understand what you're about. Especially for very complex websites, this can really become very, very funny, very, very interesting. And it can, in some cases, it can even like take several minutes or even more to generate this type of graph. Now, it took like no time because this is a small website and this is a simple graph, but for bigger ones, you may actually wait a lot for this to get done. Okay, so that's all for me, and see you in the next video. Bye-bye.